When making games, drawing debug shapes can be very useful. It helps you to understand what is happening and better visualize your code actions. Here we'll make our own custom system to draw simple lines and shapes from our code by creating the meshes in real time. Let's start by creating the node to host our system and name it DebugDraw. Inside it, let's add a mesh instance 3D, which will render our debug drawings into the screen. For the mesh type, we need to create one of the immediate mesh types. This type of mesh allows us to create and change our mesh in real time inside our code. Now, let's start making our script. Add a script to the DebugDraw node. Drag the mesh instance node inside the script, and while holding Ctrl, release it. This will automatically create the code that gets the reference for that node, and rename the variable name to drawDebug. We'll be using this variable to draw our debug meshes. Now, let's create our drawLine function, passing a point A and point B vector 3 for the position where the line starts and ends, and a color for the line's color. We make a quick sanity check to not draw lines if the points are the same. And finally, we check if the drawDebug.mesh is of type of immediate mesh, so the code doesn't break if we forgot to set up the mesh type correctly. To start drawing in our immediate mesh, we need to make it ready first. We use drawDebug.mesh.surfaceBegin and set the type of drawing to mesh primitive lines to draw lines between the points. Then, we set the color of the mesh with mesh.surfaceSetColor and pass our color. This will set the vertex color for any future vertex added. We then start adding points to the mesh with mesh.surfaceAddVertex and adding our point A and point B to the mesh. After it's done, we end it by calling mesh.surfaceAnd. And finally, let's create our physics process function. Here, we want to clear our mesh every physics frame, so it's only drawing lines executed until that frame. We can do that by calling the mesh.clearSurfaces to reset our mesh. And to test our code, let's simply call the drawLine after it, passing the vector3.up, which is 001 for the starting point, and multiplying it by 10 to get the position 0010 for the end. If we run our game now, we can see a vertical line in our scene. But you'll notice that the color is not working. To make our colors work, we need to select our mesh instance 3D node and create an override material for it. And inside that material, set vertex color to use as albedo. Now we can see the line is red. And if we pass the custom color, we can see that it works as well. You can now delete the drawLine call from our code. Next, we need to get access to these drawLine functions from anywhere in our code, and that's very easy to do by using autoloads. First, we need to turn our DebugDraw node into its own scene. Right-click it and select Save Branch as Scene, and then save it. Now, inside our project settings, open up the autoload tab, click on the folder icon, and select the scene we just created. Give it the name DebugDraw and click on Add. We can see our currently active autoloads here now. When the game starts, it will automatically load that scene and give us a global class named DebugDraw that we can use from any script. And don't forget to delete that previous DebugDraw node from our scene too. Let's test this by creating a new script. On the process function, if we start typing DebugDraw, you'll see that the autocomplete is already working. We can call the drawLine functions like before and run the game. And it is working. But passing two points to create a line is not always ideal. So let's make some changes to our DebugDraw code. Here we'll create a drawLine relative function. This will use a point A as the start of the line, and the point B as the increment to that line, which is very useful when drawing forces and directions. Inside it, we simply pass the second parameter as the sum of both points. We can now call the drawLine relative to make a line that starts at 001 and goes 1 unit to the right. And after adding some movement to our character, we can call our new debugLine function to show its front direction in green and its speed direction in red. One big problem though is that those lines are barely visible. So instead of lines, let's make some real 3D meshes. Here I took the code to generate Godot's own raycast 3D node debugLine and translate it to DigiScript. It uses a primitive triangle strip and some math to make a pointed rectangle, a triangle with a square top. The big advantage of this is that now you can pass a thickness parameter to make it more visible. And based on that, I changed it to make it do normal rectangle shapes instead, without the pointy end, which is better to see the length of things. The only change made from the original code to make it rectangle was to remove the normal variable divided by 3 when creating the vertices. I added some input to change its movement, and it's now using the thick lines. Here we can already see that the results are much easier to see. And we can customize the line thickness and colors in any way we want. I also add a variable useDebugDraw so we can enable and disable debug shapes when we want. And that's it! We can now use debug shapes in our 3D games to better experiment and test our code, using them to visually see forces and code actions, and also how to use the immediate mesh to custom craft our own custom meshes. I hope you liked this video, thanks for watching, and until next time!